Hey, welcome back everyone, General Tony here, coming back with a brand new COC episode. So firstly, I would like to say my cold has got a little bit better, guys, so hopefully my voice doesn't sound as squeaky right now, but I'm not really too sure. It does sound quite high pitch, so hopefully that does go back to normal over the next 24 to 48 hours. So we're about to get ourselves into something a little bit different in this episode. Just before we do, obviously there is no sneak peeks today, there was no sneak peeks yesterday, and I doubt we are going to get any for the rest of this month, guys. So this is currently, I think, the 27th, Tuesday the 27th of September 2016, and it is another day where COC slowly slips away. So no sneak peeks, hopefully we will receive them next week, maybe halfway through this week. Just stay tuned to the channel, guys. As soon as the first one is released, of course, you will receive the information on this channel. So that, of course, means you have to subscribe to the channel. So make sure you drop a sub, guys. So that, of course, means you do have to subscribe to the channel. So make sure you drop a sub if this is the first time you are seeing me. We are approaching 750,000 subscribers. So the first thing we are going to do is gem ourselves up this wonderful, wonderful Valkyrie army. So what we're about to do, we are going to show you the quickest method to 3-star, maybe 2-star, okay, not 3-star. We're going to show you the quickest method to destroy a base. Now, when I say destroy, I basically mean rip the heart out of it. So we're going to go for the Eagle Artillery, the Inferno Towers, and of course the Town Hall. Hopefully we can 2-star the base in maybe 15 to 20 seconds. So I'm talking that quick. So the trick to taking down a base really quickly is to find a troll base, guys. So that is right. Wow, look at that as well. He's got no wall there, which means we have free access into the Eagle Artillery. Now, this is going to be hilarious. We are surely going to be taking down this base. What happens if we drop a wall breaker in there? Wall breaker is going to trigger the big bomb. That's awesome. Okay, so I reckon we can take down the Inferno Towers, the Eagle Artillery, the Town Hall, the Heroes, everything in the center in 10 seconds. Take a guess in that comment section, guys. How many seconds do you think it is going to take us? Now, there are actually some walls around the Town Hall, but that doesn't really matter. We've got 3 rage spells, 1 heal spell, and 1 free spell. We're going to be dropping the free spell on the Eagle Artillery and, of course, the actual Inferno Tower. So here we go. We're going to drop down the rage spell first. Double Golem goes in. King, Queen, Grand Warden, and now here go the Valkyries, guys. We're going to pop the Grand Warden's ability right there. There goes the poison spell and the heal spell and another rage spell. Check this out, guys. All the spells have gone down. We're going to drop another rage spell down on the Valkyries. Here we go, making their way into the base. The last rage spell has already gone down. I don't know how long that took, but we have just destroyed this base in seconds. Unfortunately, we just missed the Queen's ability. That is the worst thing about these attacks. It's really hard to keep an eye on the heroes, but check it out. We've destroyed this base. Now, we are only up to 54% so far, but it's all about tearing the heart out. We have torn the heart out of this base. There is nothing really remaining, and we still have loads of Valkyries left. So, as I said, it's not about seeing how fast you can get the 3-star. It's about getting the 2-star and tearing the center of the base into pieces. So, we got a 2-star in, you know, seconds. The Valkyries are now going to take a lot longer to get a 3-star, but the likelihood is they're not actually going to get a 3-star because, of course, Valkyries do not shoot over walls. They have to go through the walls, and by the time they make it onto the other side, the likelihood is that the poor girls are going to be shot by cannons, expos, wizard towers, archer towers, all of that good stuff. So the Valkyries, although they are really quick, the 3-star is never usually an option if you only bring Valkyries and golems. No wizards, no bowlers, nothing like that, no hog riders. Anything that can shoot over the wall or jump over the wall is always going to be beneficial. So we are going to end this raid here. We are going to get ourselves into a second live attack. This time, we're not going to use golems. We are only going to use a Valkyrie army. So this is kind of like a weird episode. Now, we are slowly pushing up towards 4,000 trophies. We have just hit the Champions 1 League, so we only need another 252 trophies before we are finally back inside of the Titans League. So if you don't know, if you did miss, last week's episodes, we dropped all the way back down to, I think we actually dropped to about 2,000 cups. No, we dropped below that. We dropped to about 1,800. So we've gone from 1,800 to 3,800, almost 4,000 in about a week, week and a half. So that's pretty damn awesome. So 3 rage spells, 1 freeze, 1 heal, and a single poison. Now we just need to gem ourselves the heroes, and we're ready to get ourselves into the second live attack. I really feel that my voice is really sounding squeaky. So it honestly doesn't sound this squeaky usually, guys. It's just the cold I've got. I've got like a really blocked nose, and it just feels weird. It really does just feel weird. So check it out. We're about to get ourselves into a second live attack. So just while this is searching for a base, whilst we are searching for a black hole troll base, I wanted to talk about Supercell, guys, and what this next update has to bring. So obviously, for those of you that do not know, I pretty much follow Supercell every single day on social media. I even follow Clash Royale to see what kind of new features they're bringing into the game. Even though I don't even play that anymore, I still follow them. So pretty much Supercell said that they actually wanted to release the update by the middle to the end of September. Now that includes the actual update launch day. Now obviously, this is September 27th. We haven't even received a single sneak peek, so I'm afraid to say the likelihood is that we're not gonna be receiving the update till maybe the second week of October. So still maybe another 2 weeks away. So check this out, we've landed on this base. Now for some reason there seems to be so many black hole troll bases inside of the Champions League right now, and I'm not really sure why. So we're gonna test this out by dropping in a Valkyrie. Now the problem with this base is we don't have a single, not a single wall breaker. So that could cause an issue. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna try and play smart here. We're gonna drop down a rage spell. We're going to pop the Grand Warden's ability, chuck in a poison spell, see if we can clear loads of these buildings. There goes the King's ability, hopefully going to take out loads of those actual. There goes the Queen's ability now as well. And here go the other Valkyries. So hopefully we can get these Valkyries going into the base. There goes the poison spell, the heal spell, the rage spell. Everything is now being dropped down. The hero's abilities have been used. We did make it into the center. Once again, the base was destroyed in quite a few seconds. Unfortunately, this time, it doesn't look like we will be getting as high of a percentage. The Valkyries seem to be melting pretty quickly. I don't know if we're going to get a 2-star, guys. The Wizard Tower is about to connect onto the Valkyries, but they've split up. This could be a good thing. So they've split up. Now they've joined back together. They're going to take out that second Wizard Tower, but he's doing a lot of damage. Now, the great thing about the Valkyries is they do have relatively high hit points, but Supercell actually buffed them. But during the buff, they decreased the hit points and increased the actual attack value. So that's pretty awesome, but it's also, you know, going to decrease the health on the Valkyries. So the Valkyries just about faded, but we did manage to grab a total of 52%. And of course, another very quick beatdown on that base. So that actually grabbed us another 10 trophies. So we are closing in on 3,900. So there is a couple of other troops which can destroy bases pretty quickly, and we're going to test that out right now. So what other troop can do severe damage in seconds? It used to be the Witch. The Witch could just flow from one side of the base to the other and destroy it. But obviously that doesn't happen anymore. Well, it hasn't happened for a very long time. So the only other troop which I can think about which does that sort of damage are the Wall Breakers. Yes, guys, we are about to attack a troll base using 40 Wall Breakers. 42 Wall Breakers. This is going to be hilarious. And then we're going to fill the rest of the spaces with Valkyries. So this is definitely going to be one of the weirdest attack strategies we have done for quite some time on the channel. We just drop a couple of those Valkyries out. Let's bring some more Wall Breakers. Two more Wall Breakers. And of course, it is going to be the Treble Rage, single free, single heal, and of course a single, let's go for an Earthquake spell this time. Let's forget about the poison. So we need to gem ourselves the heroes. There's the King. Need to gem the Grand Warden. And of course, finally, we need to gem the Queen. Now, just before we do get into the live attack, let's get a screenshot of these awesome Wall Breakers. So here we go, guys. 44 Wall Breakers, screenshot taken. It's time to get ourselves into a live attack. Now, once again, we are looking for a troll base, a black hole troll base. As I said, there are loads of them around inside of the Champions League right now. So check this out, we have finally just landed on this black hole troll base. It took so long to find it, but we've done it. We have landed on a Town Hall 11 black hole troll base, which is looking menacing. So we're gonna start off by dropping into Wall Breakers just to see what's inside of the core. So it looks like this is gonna be one awesome challenge. So we're gonna drop down the Earthquake spell just to damage everything inside of the center. Now we are ready. We are really ready to rumble inside of here. This is going to be insane. This is going to be hilarious. This is going to be a true challenge. So we're going to drop down the rage spell. King, Queen, Grand Warden. Going to pop the Grand Warden's ability. Here we go, guys. Wall Breakers should go schizo. We've still got loads of Wall Breakers held back. We're going to drop down the free spell on the left-hand side. We've already dropped down the hero's abilities. What has happened? What has happened? We're still going to drop down some more Wall Breakers. We need to drop down a rage spell. Send in the Wall Breakers. Here we go. Let's see what happens. There's all of the Wall Breakers gone in, guys. Oh, we're going to be able to take down that second Inferno Tower. We've already got the 1-star, but it's about the 2-star. The Queen has taken down the second multi-target Inferno Tower, but the guys, our Wall Breakers have died. Obviously, they've died. They weren't going to survive too long. In fact, they're Kamikaze Warriors, so they killed themselves anyway, but they definitely died a lot quicker than I thought they would. We didn't manage to grab the Eagle Artillery, but damn, that was insane. So we are going to end this episode here. I'm about to go jump in the shower. My nose is running like hell. I really need to clean up my boogers. So I will see you very shortly in a couple of hours' time for the second episode, guys. We are going to do something a little bit different, so stay tuned to the channel. I will see you shortly. Have a great Tuesday. Love you all. Peace out.